Hello, I'm Johara Singaporensis, a Singapore freshwater crab, but you can just call me Joe. And I want to tell you about some magical forests called mangroves. In this video, I'm going to tell you about some of the amazing wildlife which live in mangroves. Mangroves mainly grow along tropical coastal waters. These areas experience high tides and low tides, a lot of salt water and soft, muddy soil, low in oxygen. Any wildlife that lives in mangroves has to adapt in clever ways to cope with these challenging conditions. My friend Max the mangrove tree lives in the mangroves in the Sungai Buloh Wetland Reserve. Mangrove trees like Max have special roots which give them stability in the soft mud and allow them to breathe the air above the water. And these roots don't just help Max, they're also very useful to lots of other mangrove dwellers. For many species of animals, mangrove roots provide shelter from strong waves and resting spots for birds. They also give protection from predators and safe breeding grounds and nurseries for marine life such as shellfish, crabs, worms, and young fish like sea bass and barramundi, who spend their early years swimming among the thick tangles of mangrove roots. As soon as they are large enough to fend for themselves, they head out to sea. Max's neighbors need to be tough to survive in the muddy waters of the mangroves, and they don't come much tougher than the saltwater crocodile. As the world's largest living reptile, this crocodile can move quickly on land, but its body is mainly adapted for life in the water. If you're lucky enough to spot a saltwater crocodile, keep your distance and stay away from the water's edge. But don't be too alarmed, because its presence is good news. As an apex predator at the top of the food chain, it indicates a very healthy ecosystem. The same applies if you see a Malayan water monitor or a mangrove pit viper. Both these reptiles are well camouflaged in the mangroves, allowing them to bask peacefully in the sun or hunt for food without being seen by other animals. As a freshwater crab, I couldn't survive in mangrove saltwater, but some of my distant crab cousins thrive. Like the tree-climbing crab, which during low tide forages for food, such as leaves or dead animals, in the mud at the bottom of the mangrove. Then, just before high tide, it quickly grabs food and scuttles up the trees to escape predators in the water. Or the mangrove horseshoe crab, which despite its name, is more closely related to spiders and scorpions. Happily, the crab doesn't bite or sting, and its rather scary-looking tail helps it to right itself when it's flipped over by waves. And the tail has clearly been doing a great job, because horseshoe crabs have been around since the days of the dinosaurs, about 400 million years ago. Among many other mangrove dwellers is the giant mudskipper, an amphibious fish which can survive on both land and water. During high tide, the giant mudskipper lounges on mangrove roots, but at low tide, it can be spotted in pools of muddy water where it lives. Wading about in the same water, stalking crabs, fish, and mollusks are shorebirds like this egret, along with many different species of birds which roost in mangrove trees. Like Max, some species are permanent residents of the mangroves, but there are lots of flying visitors too. Every year, from September to March, millions of migratory shorebirds flee the harsh winters in the north by flying thousands of kilometers south. Their routes are called flyways, and Singapore's Sungai Buloh Wetland Reserve is situated on one of the greatest, the East Asian Australasian Flyway, which stretches from Alaska and the Russian Far East across Southeast Asia to Australia and New Zealand. mangroves have become regular stopovers for hundreds of species of migratory birds, such as peregrine falcons, godwits, whimbrels and wagtails, to rest and refuel on the abundant marine wildlife before continuing their long and arduous journeys across the world. Mangroves do so much for so many different species on Earth, including people. They really are marvelous. And the more mangroves there are, the better. I'll be telling you more about them in the rest of the series. But in the meantime, let's all max the mangroves!